So I recently got in trouble with a couple of friends.
There. It's going to be okay.
Hey, what's happening here then?
Ash broke up with them.
Oh no, that's terrible. And Ash was way too good for you.
What?
Oh, I just meant that you probably won't find someone as good as that again.
Can you not see that you're upsetting them?
I think you'll find that it was actually Ash who upset them by deciding to leave forever.
Please just stop.
Well, I wish you'd stop. Stop crying, that is. I mean, seriously, your cry is so annoying. Well, now look what you've done. Correction, what Ash has done. Now, I know what you're thinking. How did I become such a good friend? And honestly, some people are just born with a good heart. But I know what you're probably also thinking. Why wouldn't I just accept that I was making the situation worse? And the truth is, it was to make a point about climate change. The reality is, of course, that more than one thing can make you sad at the same time, just like more than one thing can affect climate questions at the same time. I'll explain what I mean. Let's start with what climate change can cause. Take forest fires. In general, it's not possible to say that climate change causes these fires. There are many other things that can trigger them. But climate change can make them worse. It does this by providing fuel for the fire with hotter and often drier conditions. So for example, the Australian bushfires of 2019-2020 were estimated to be made a third more likely because of climate change. But when I've spoken about this on my channel, I've got comments saying things like,
"How can you be so stupid? Everyone knows the fires were caused by arsonists, nothing to do with climate change."
Now, putting aside for the moment whether arsonists did indeed start these bushfires, which, climate change can clearly still have made them worse. Just like if a breakup made you start crying,
you're still making it worse by being so rude.
The thing is, some people just deny this logic when it comes to climate change, and not just what climate change can cause, but also what causes climate change. Let's recap the basics. We know that humans are causing basically all the warming that we're seeing, and that carbon dioxide is the biggest factor in that, which is why we focus on carbon dioxide emissions. But no climate scientist would deny that there are other factors. This includes other human factors like methane heating or aerosols cooling the climate. And there are other natural factors too, such as volcanoes or changes in the sun's intensity. Though, just to reiterate, there is zero evidence that these are behind the changes we're seeing. But when you are obsessed with single causes, you say things like,
"How can you blame me for making you sad? If I'm the cause of your sadness, how come you've cried loads of times when I wasn't even there? Like when you watched Toy Story 3, or that time you read the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change special report on 1.5 degrees of global warming."
Now, of course, this doesn't make any sense, since
just because I was sad at other times for other reasons, that doesn't let you off the hook. None of those things are happening now, but you are insulting me now.
Honestly, this is exactly the kind of thing people say about climate change. That just because the climate changed due to natural causes in Earth's past, that must be what's causing the changes we're seeing today. Even though, once again, there is no evidence for natural factors changing in a way that would explain what we're seeing today, and we're staring at a greenhouse gas-shaped smoking gun. For more on this, check out my episode all about the essential detective work that goes into identifying carbon dioxide as the culprit. Look, I get that we want the world to be simple. We want to just say that A causes B. But in the real world, there's often a tangle of factors. But the more climate scientists untangle this mess, the clearer the picture becomes. Yes, lots of things can influence extreme weather events, but one of those things is climate change. And yes, lots of things can, in theory, change the climate. But today we see that the thing changing the climate is us. And that means that we also have the power to stop it.
I'm sorry, yeah? Look, have a recycled tissue.
Thank you.
I just wanted to say a special thank you to Harry Eakins and all my other patrons over at Patreon. Your support makes this channel possible. If you'd like to join them, then the link is down here. And if you'd like to watch my video all about climate change detective work, the link's over here. Okay, until next time. Bye.